Hello, I'm feeling good today because I want to talk about coffee and blood pressure. What's the relationship between coffee and blood pressure? Does coffee actually raise your blood pressure when you drink it? If you got high blood pressure, should you be drinking coffee? That's what's coming up next. I'll see you in a couple of seconds.
If you want 2020 ideas to better health, you've come to the right channel, hosted by the warm and lovely Dr. Joe. Now, for today's topic, please welcome on stage, Dr. Joe.
Hello, welcome back. I'm Dr. Joe of the drjoe.com. Well, if this is your first time on this channel, can I extend a warm welcome to you? This is your home of 2020 ideas to better health. So if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. So, like I said, I'm feeling good today because I want to talk about coffee and blood pressure, the relationship between coffee and blood pressure, whether it raises blood pressure or not. Now, for the purpose of this presentation, I'm going to split it into three. The first thing I want to talk about is the science, and then I'm going to talk about the relationship between coffee and blood pressure for the general population, and then I'm going to talk specifically about coffee and blood pressure for people who've got high blood pressure. And I'm going to round up with one or two suggestions, especially for people who've got high blood pressure. So let's get cracking.
I have to say that the relationship between coffee use and blood pressure is not very straightforward. And this is actually exemplified in this recent study that is telling us that the most recent findings aimed at clarifying the role of caffeine consumption and high blood pressure are conflicting and difficult to interpret. And that's because you have studies like this one that tells us that regular caffeine intake actually does increase blood pressure. However, when ingested through coffee, the blood pressure effect is small. This is also shown by this other review that looked at quite a number of studies, pulled them together, and their conclusion was that in hypertensive individuals, caffeine intake produces an acute increase in blood pressure for about 3 hours or thereabout. However, current evidence does not support an association between longer-term coffee consumption and increased blood pressure, or between habitual coffee consumption and increase in cardiovascular disease. So, you've got that, and you also have this one here that talks about the fact that actually the association between coffee consumption and cardiovascular disease is inverse, in which case, you know, people who use coffee actually do reduce their risk of cardiovascular disease. So you've got all of these conflicting messages here, and it's a little bit difficult to just draw straightforward conclusions in all of this. And I'll tell you next what I actually think of all of this, because I'm going to tell you what my position is and what I will advise you to do if you are, you know, somebody who is a subscriber to this channel.
So here are a few facts for the general population. Coffee is a vasoconstrictor. What is a vasoconstrictor? A vasoconstrictor is an agent that has the ability to stiffen the walls of the blood vessels. So if what this means is that if the blood vessel walls are not relaxed, the pressure within the vessel is going to rise. So essentially, because coffee is a vasoconstrictor, coffee will raise your blood pressure. That is a fact. If it raises our blood pressure, by how much? Well, it's a modest rise. So say, for instance, your systolic blood pressure, which is the top value, is about 145. You should expect that if you drink coffee, your blood pressure might rise up to about 153, the systolic that is, 153 to about 155. Right? So, you know, it's a modest rise. So if this rise does happen, how long does it last? Well, you'll be glad to know that the rise is temporary and the effect will last for an average of about 3 hours. So that's good. What does that also mean? Well, the implication of that is that if we consume coffee on a regular basis, it doesn't have any potential to cause us any long-term damage to our cardiovascular health because the effect is temporary. So that's good news all around for the general population. So let me say a word or two about coffee and those of us who got high blood pressure. We've already established that coffee does have a pressor effect on our blood vessels, which means we expect a rise in our blood pressure. Now, for those of us who've got high blood pressure, that pressor effect is stronger. So for those of us who got high blood pressure, we should expect a higher rise in our blood pressure compared to somebody who hasn't got high blood pressure. And here's the other thing. that rise in blood pressure is not responsive to blood pressure medications. So if you take your blood pressure medication in the hope that you want to bring your blood pressure down after consuming coffee when you have a rise, you probably will be disappointed with the response you're going to get. Here is another implication for you if you got high blood pressure and you are a habitual coffee drinker. We've already established that the espresso effect of the coffee or caffeine will last for about 3 hours. Now, if you imagine that after consuming your coffee and in 3 hours time, when the effect, the espresso effect is beginning to wear off, if you top up with another cup of coffee, then the blood pressure goes up again. And then same thing happens again when you're having another coffee crash and you need to top up again, your blood pressure goes up again. So in effect, you might have a sustainable high blood pressure throughout the day if you're drinking several cups of coffee a day. So that's just something to bear at the back of your mind if you drink coffee and you've got high blood pressure. Now, there's another huge thing that you need to be aware of. There are genetic differences between the way we handle our coffee. Each of us, we have, you know, slow metabolizers, and then we've got fast metabolizers, and that's shown by this study here. Now, some people who are fast metabolizers, they will deal with their coffee load very quickly. But in the same vein, those of us who are slow metabolizers, we're going to take a longer time for us to actually offload our coffee from our system, which means if you've got high blood pressure, there's a good chance that your blood pressure may be sustainably high over a longer period if you're a slow metabolizer. So this is something that you have to also bear at the back of your mind if you've got high blood pressure and you drink coffee. For me, I'm a slow metabolizer, and I know that the effect does last a good number of hours. So after all this, do I have any suggestions for you? Of course I do. For the general public, if you don't have any high blood pressure, you're fine. You should not be worried about the effect of coffee on your blood pressure at all. The effect is temporary, and it doesn't have any long-term damage on your cardiovascular health. So that's fine. But if you've got high blood pressure, then you need to be extra careful. And I want you to do two tests. One is, the first test is, I want you to test to see how high your blood pressure actually goes up by when you drink coffee. The second test is, I want you to test for whether you're a slow metabolizer or a fast metabolizer. So how do you do this? I want you to test your blood pressure 30 minutes after you've had your cup of coffee, 1 hour after you've had your cup of coffee, 2 hours, as well as 3 hours. Now, if your blood pressure is still high after 2, 3, or 4 hours time, then you are a slow metabolizer, in which case you need to be very careful. And here's my other suggestion. I want you to switch to the decaffeinated variety. It is safer, and you still enjoy your coffee because the aroma is still the same, the taste is the same. There's no difference at all between them apart from the caffeine content. So decaf is one suggestion. My second suggestion is that if you must drink the caffeinated regular coffee, then please limit yourself to just one cup of coffee a day. It works. You can then have the decaffeinated variety for the rest of the day, and you should be fine. Now, if you enjoyed this video, hit the like button, give it a thumbs up as usual. And I want you to tell me what your tolerance level is. Are you a slow metabolizer? Are you a fast metabolizer? Are you very sensitive to coffee? Are you very tolerant to coffee? Leave your comments in the comment section. I'm a very sensitive person. I'm very sensitive to caffeine. So I want to know all about your coffee sensitivity right there in the comment section, please. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. Now, if you want to learn more about all of this, I've written a longer article on my blog. The link is going to be in the video description right there. And if you want to read more about it, go to my blog, read all about it there. I think that's about it. Until next time, well, this is Dr. Joe signing out. Enjoy your coffee. Be safe. This is Dr. Joe signing out a second time.